Okay, from side mount. So, for me, when I start side mount, I always want to try to control this elbow, this arm. Because a lot of times he's going to try to get it in and try to create a frame. So I want to try to deal with that before it becomes a problem. I just pin it to the floor, slide my knee across, and then always look for that wrist lock. It's going to be there more than you think. Once I get here, I want to isolate this arm by grabbing my own collar. And then from here, I'm looking to try to attack the neck because he's not giving me his arm. So I'm going to snake through. I'm going to go thumb in the collar, hand as low as I can go here. I drop my weight, trying to put my elbow to the floor. And some guys will tap here. It's painful. It's not always a good choke. And then I'll look to take my elbow and kind of pop the top off there a little bit. So it's down and then rotating that elbow upwards. So again, we're in side control. You can control the collar first if you want. Securing this arm, I'm kind of using my ear and my shoulder to pinch it here, like I'm holding my phone without hands. Switch my hip, push this arm to the floor, slide my knee across, look for that little wrist lock. It's gonna be there. And then again, when I settle in here, I'm gonna look to attack this neck, thumb in the collar, elbow to the floor, and then try to rotate upwards. One more time. From side control, control this arm, look to control this one, slide the knee, look for that wrist lock. Snake the hand across the neck, thumb in the collar, you can also just grab the shoulder, elbow to the floor, and then look to pop the top off. So again, we're in side control, looking to isolate the arms. Sliding that knee across again, always looking for that. So sometimes this is here. A nice sneaky one is I'm gonna go four fingers in the collar here and I'm gonna loop the elbow over to the floor. Once I'm here, the second hand is gonna grab that collar to take the slack out. And then same kind of thing, I rotate my elbow to get the tap. Again, isolate. Check. This time I'm going four fingers in. I'm looping elbow to the floor. This second hand is gonna grab the collar to take the slack out, make it more of a strangle than a crush. And then I circle that elbow to get the finish. One more time. Isolate the arms, checking for that wrist lock. Four fingers in, looping it, taking out the slack, and then circling to get the submission. Again, trying to isolate these arms. Here. Sometimes this collar's already open. If not, I'll open it. I'm gonna grab pretty low here. I pass it across. I'm snaking under the head. And then I pass it back nice and tight. Take the slack out. Look at how I'm gonna pull this hand to the other side. From here, now I need to tighten it. So what I'm gonna do is my hand's gonna go to a palm block on this side. So he doesn't follow me as I start to circle. I do a windshield wipe. I slide and I cover. Then my head is gonna come up, my shoulders pressures down. Now my head becomes the block. Now my hand's free. I'm gonna trap this wrist and I'm gonna start to circle over his head. Good shoulder pressure here, trying to keep him flat on the floor. I'll check with one knee over the head to see if it's tight enough. Sometimes it is. Sometimes you have to walk all the way to that second knee and then just cinch it and get the tap. Once, pass it back twice, take that slack out, windshield wipe, palm block, moving my body, and stays down, blocking the hip, pull this wrist, and start to make my walk. Trying to get the tap in, I'll loosen. Again, if you need that final detail, my hand's gonna come underneath, grabbing some fabric just to turn his head back into it. Okay, another option from that last choke. Same thing, controlling the collar, always trying to control these limbs, looking for that. Again, I open this collar, and sometimes when I look to pass this, his head's tucked up pretty high and I don't wanna, it's not there, so I'm just gonna pass it. Watch this, no pass. I put it under. Once I can see my hand, I'm gonna loop, and I come back down. So again, like that first kind of paper cutter, I can drop and pop the top off, but what's a nice detail here is, watch my hand grab my own collar, and I start taking the slack out this way. Now, once I get a good grip and I pull on that and I drop that elbow, he's feeling a different kind of choke. He's feeling a strangle. So again, we're here, still going through these chokes, opening the collar. I can go in front and pass it, or I can just go underneath. Once I see this, I make my loop, drop my elbow. This hand's looking to take the slack out. I'm pulling to take that slack out as I drop my elbow. And again, I rotate that head up, trying to pop that top off. One more time. Control. Here. Open. I can go in front, or I can go underneath. Loop. Swoop. And pull. Same thing, controlling. Controlling. This time, we'll say the other collar's open. A little bit tougher to get to, but once you get this one, it's much tighter. So I pass it across again, taking the slack out here. This time, I don't have to move as much. I'm still gonna palm block and I'll windshield wipe, but on this one, as soon as my head goes across to the other side, almost always they're tapping right there. From here, isolating here. So sometimes the other collar's already open, or you can open it. It's a little bit sneaky. He doesn't see it coming as much. I'll pass it off here. Make my switch, pass it back here. Now I'm coming underneath, and again, I wanna take that slack out. Windshield wipe, palm block, and again, on this one, all I gotta do is get my head to the other side, shoulder down, and cinching it a little bit here, and this one's super tight. One more time. Slack out, and then she'll wipe. Palm block, and just move my head to the other side as I pull. Super tight.